So today we are very lucky to have with us Vice-Chancellor and Principal of the University of Johannesburg, Professor Tshilidzi Marwala. Professor Marwala is a very accomplished scholar and educationist who has authored over 15 books in the area of artificial intelligence. As you know, FISU is launching an extremely important, extremely ambitious project in just a few days from now. It is the FISU Healthy Campus Project. And the University of Johannesburg, under your leadership, has in fact very closely partnered FISU with this project. You're one of the seven pilot universities. You know some of the intricacies of this project. So what, according to you, are the real strengths that can come from this project?
Well, I think, firstly, I would like just to say that the issue of health and wellness and sports are interconnected. A healthy human being is a productive human being. Here at the University of Johannesburg, we have 52,000 students. And these students, one of the things that worry me about our students is whether they are doing enough physical exercises. It might be as simple as just taking a walk. I understand that some of our students, on average, they are only walking for 1.5 kilometers, which is quite low for people, for anybody. Yeah. So this project, if there is something that I want to come out of this project, is to make our staff and students much more active.
Yes, and that's really the objective in a general sense of this project. So while we count on the support of universities like yours in this, what do you see as the real value for the university? From the university's point of view, what is the value in them coming on board and joining FISU's Healthy Campus Project?
Well, I mean, FISU is a very important organization. I personally serve on the FISU academic advisory board. I believe that FISU has done fantastic job, and this is one of the evidence that shows that FISU is doing an excellent job. The reason why we are much more excited about this is because FISU is very experienced in sports. They understand sports much better than we do. Therefore, partnering with an organization such as FISU can only take us to a higher level. We would like to benefit from their expertise, all this data that they have gathered over the years on the best practices, on what needs to be done to have an active student and staff population in a campus like ours. We are hoping that FISU is going to advise us on how we can be able to take that to another level.
Yes, and ideally, this is what the universities will be able to gain, as you said, from this platform, the Healthy Campus platform that will be launched in a matter of days now. The best part of it is that universities around the world can register, can log on, and then, as you said, they can gain from best practices and, you know, the best knowledge from everywhere in the world, and that's really what is to be gained from being on this platform. But you speak of
absolutely. Yeah. Maybe just to add a little bit, I think one of the things that has really been nudging me, bothering me for quite a while is how do we nudge people to be physically active? Not force, nudge. How do we nudge? What are the sort of incentives that we need to put into place for our staff and students to be active? And I think this platform is actually going to, I hope it is going to assist us in nudging our people to be physically active.
And it's a tall task, as you said, you know, to nudge people to really start getting active. Now, I understand that the University of Johannesburg, or UJ, as it is affectionately called, has four large campuses. You said yourself, you're talking about 52,000 students. What are the current policies or programs or any initiatives that you have tried so far on your campuses in this regard to get people moving? And something, you know, anything that's worked, that according to you has really created some result?
Yeah. Well, I mean, we are the large universities, and our campuses are sometimes moving from one part of the campus to another. It's 25 kilometers, 30 kilometers apart. What have we done? We obviously have excellent gyms in all our campuses. So we make sure that the resources are available for our people to get into an exercise mode. Very, very important. Secondly, we run the marathons, you know, where the walk, not marathons, walks, where we get all our staff and students as much as we can, obviously, because it is a voluntary matter, to basically walk for fun, but walk for health. And we get sponsorship with people who come from outside, they come and walk with us. And these are some of the mechanisms that we are putting into place to make sure that our people are physically active. At all costs, at all levels, we encourage our people to use steps instead of using elevators in the morning, just to get them to be moving. So these are some of the things that we have done.
Yeah.
Obviously, we have competitive sports at the University of Johannesburg. We have a dynamic rugby team, one of the best in the country. We have soccer team, we have hockey. Almost all the sports are played here, certainly the summer sports are played here at the University of Johannesburg. And we incentivize our students to participate in those. How do we do that? We invest quite extensively in the infrastructure, the coaches, so that people can be assisted if they need coaching, and so on and so forth. So those are some of the mechanisms that we have put into place for us to get our campus moving.
Okay, so just to recap quickly, you said some very important things there. One, of course, you said about access and infrastructure. Providing that firstly to all the students is really step one to make sure that students have somewhere to go and something to do. But you also talked about creating community events like the walks that you mentioned, and about imbibing the daily practices like taking steps instead of elevators. So all of this is really what the Healthy Campus Project is going to be about. And it's important that, you know, that entire student population beyond those elite athletes start thinking about sport and movement and activity in the way that we want them to. So would you say that you're a believer in the theory that regular physical activity also improves mental capacity? Because, you know, in students, you have the two groups, one that are the sporty ones, and then the others who think that, okay, I'm the academic kind, and for me, the most important thing is only my studies. So what do you believe?
Scientific studies have demonstrated beyond the shadow of any doubt that being physically active through regular walks actually has an impact on diseases such as depression, anxiety, ADHD, for instance. You know, yeah. So we believe that those studies are valid. And those studies, we use those studies in order to encourage our people to be physically active. It's not just about health, you know. We tend to think the relationship between physical activity and health is very well established. The relationship that people don't really, have not really taken that seriously is the relationship between physical activity and mental wellness,
yes,
the ability to concentrate more in class, the ability to be alert in class, you know. So in a way, there is a very strong relationship between physical activities through sports and how well people can be able to do academically, you know, very, very important. Of course, I'm not even covering other benefits that sports is one of the mechanisms of building leadership capacity in young students. All of a sudden, if you are a captain of your team, you develop skills that you are going to use even when you leave the academic reality and go into the workforce. Competitive sports is very, very important for building resilience, leadership skills, and building a well-rounded person, which is important in the era we are living in.
Absolutely. And that's, you know, that's so closely aligned with FISU's objectives, with FISU's mission and vision. And that's exactly what FISU sets out to do with this huge community of millions of university students around the world. Now, maybe you can tell us a little bit more about, you know, what you have done with this fourth industrial revolution on your campuses, because we understand you were appointed as deputy chair of the Presidential Commission on the Fourth Industrial Revolution. And since then, you've been instrumental in bringing about certain change on your campus.
We have developed, for example, an app called Hear It Loud, which is a sound amplifier for people with hearing impairment. For example, we have digital timetables here at the University of Johannesburg. And also, we are working on an app now, which is going to, to basically be looking at the relationship between music genre and level of activities. And the real reason here that we are trying to achieve is that there is a relationship between our propensity to do certain exercises depending on the music that is played. For example, when I am walking, you know, I like the sort of techno type of music. It motivates me to walk even faster.
Yes.
So we are finding we are trying to develop an app that is going to find the relationship between types of music and the effect of that type of music on the motivation to do certain physical exercises.
That's extremely interesting. And I see something like that being used in the future to, as you said, motivate big student bodies to start moving, to take the steps, not take the elevator if there's some nice music going on. Yeah, why not? It inspires you. Yeah,
absolutely.
That's great to know. Now, just looking ahead, at the situation maybe a few months from now, in this post-COVID-19 scenario, what are the new challenges, according to you, that have emerged, especially for the university community, for the students, but also for the teachers?
Well, I mean, I think even before we go to post-COVID, one of our biggest worries in South Africa,
yeah,
was that our lockdown did not permit for people to walk out of their houses. So the result of that is that during this lockdown, people were less physically active than during the normal time. Of course, we engaged the government. Now we are given 3 hours to exercise in the morning. You can go out of your house and walk and run and so on and so forth. Of course, there are precautionary measures that you need to take, very, very important. And this whole idea of people, because here at the University of Johannesburg, now we are teaching through online platforms.
Right.
So the disadvantage of online platforms is that all of a sudden you don't have to walk from your room to your class.
Yeah.
You tend to sit on one chair for a longer time.
Exactly.
So we are hoping that this coronavirus is not going to, this coronavirus is not going to give us a population of people who are going to be less active than before it, you know. Now, looking forward, post coronavirus, the world is going to change quite drastically. Almost everything, the structure of the economy is going to change. Traveling is going to change. I firmly believe that people are going to be required to have chips in their bodies so that their movements can be tracked, so that if they have any infectious disease, their movement can be tracked, and people who came into contact with them or were in the same vicinity can be warned to be careful and to be alert. If they have flu type of symptoms, they can go to a doctor. So and sports is a very you have contact sports, you know.
Yes.
I've been wondering what is going to happen to contact sports going forward. If we have rapid tests for COVID-19, for example, where you get results immediately, then it is easier. What you do is before people get into the stadium, then you test them, and if they do not pass the test, then they're out. And sports organizations are used to this, you know, the drug tests that are done.
Yep.
You know, we'll have to do a similar type of test for communicable diseases. So we'll have to reimagine sports post this COVID-19. And it might fundamentally change contact sports unless we find a vaccine for this pandemic.
Yes, I think that what you say about the fact that the sports world in some ways is even prepared for this because we have the anti-doping programs and we have testing in stadia, that's a really interesting point, because yes, perhaps that's a method that could also work for prevention of communicable diseases in the future.
Absolutely.
So just wrapping up now, Professor Marwala, what do you believe should be the real objectives or the overarching goals of a project like the FISU Healthy Campus Project? What would you like to see in a couple of years from now, let's say?
I would like to see physically active staff and students on our campuses. Very, very important, especially our students, you know. Very, very important. Ultimately, I would like to see lesser rates of physically related diseases such as diabetes. Obesity is a problem here in South Africa. I would like to see less and less of that. You know, I would like to see our clinics. We have clinics in all our campuses. And many of our students are there on physical activity related type of diseases. I would like to see fewer and fewer people coming to our clinics, because the wellness wellness campus project was taken seriously by our students and staff, and we have a healthy community here at the University of Johannesburg.
Yes, well, fingers crossed for that. And, you know, we want to see those healthy communities at your university, at universities around the world. And so important that you touched upon those points there, because even as right now the world is fighting with the communicable disease, in fact, one of the biggest killers every year are these non-communicable diseases, which are lifestyle diseases that you mentioned. Diabetes and cardiovascular diseases and obesity.
Absolutely.
So, yes, and that's exactly what the Healthy Campus Project is out to combat. It is launching on the 12th of May, which is just a few days from now. And we hope to continue receiving your support in development of this project. Thank you very much.
No, thank you very much. The reason why I am not wearing a suit and a tie is because I am walking quite a great deal these days. So today I've already done 7 kilometers.
Excellent.
So I have to look sporty for me to be able to walk.
Absolutely agree with you. Thank you very much. Really appreciate you joining us. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.